Welcome back to Ozarks Fox AM. We always enjoy visits from our friends at the Discovery Center. Today, we're joined by Alex Neville Verdugo, and she is the museum director, and we're excited to hear about Steam Break and their upcoming camps.
Yes, hi, how's it going? Thanks for having me.
Of course, you're welcome anytime, by the way.
Aww,
we love
you
so bring experiments.
Thank yes,
we brought Kelly some fun and I are very scientific.
Oh, yes.
Well, thank you for the lab coats, too.
Yes. Oh, of course, you know, we gotta be prepared. So, with STEAM Break, what we do is we take the acronym STEAM. So, for those of you who don't know, STEAM equals science, technology, engineering, art, and math. And we take one of those letters and we coincide it with one day for our spring break that's coming up next week.
Awesome.
All the Springfield Public Schools and Ozarks areas have spring break, so it's going to be super exciting. So Monday will be Science Day, Tuesday Technology Day, and so forth. So I brought one idea from Science Day to share with y'all, and it's the concept of inertia. So inertia is going to be a simple concept with Newton's laws of motion. So anything that wants to be if I wasn't shaking so hard, it'd be great.
You're good.
Anything that is, pardon me.
You're good. Hey, can I hold that on my hand?
Yeah, that sounds wonderful.
Okay.
So anything that wants to be in my hand can be?
No. I am failing right now. I'm so sorry.
No, worries,
you're fine.
Okay.
This is fun.
At rest. There you go. Okay. Any ball that any object that wants to stay at rest will stay at rest. Mm-hmm. Any object that wants to be in motion, I'm going to spin it real quick, will stay in motion, which is super fun. And then any object that is at rest that would like to go into motion will be put into motion because it's applied by force. So we're going to play around with that concept with these fun little doodads right here. So go ahead and grab one for yourself.
There's Kelly.
Okay. Yes.
There you go, ma'am.
Awesome. Wonderful. So this is our inertia hat.
Okay. Do you want one too?
Sure, we'll go for it. So the funny thing about it, what we're going to do is we're going to put it on our heads.
Like this in the middle?
Right here in the middle. Yep. And you know when you were a kid and you had that little bird and it bounced on your finger? We're essentially doing the same thing. There we go. Awesome. So right now, our objects are at rest. But if we gently apply a force, then suddenly it is a force in motion, which is super fun. I was about to say, are you going to get Kelly's?
I was trying to get Kelly's, but I knocked it off her head. Sorry,
I felt like it was did you knock it off my head?
No, I was trying to get it to spin, but mine fell off too.
Now, are they equal on each side as far as where they're sitting?
They are,
mine is doing it now.
There you go.
Mine was doing it.
Kiddo's going
to... I think it has to be slow.
Yeah, for sure. Nice and gentle does it. So kiddo's gonna learn how to play with force.
Yeah, that'll.
And rotate.
There you go, Kel.
I'm trying to find that indentation in my.
There we go. Well, you're actually proving another point too. When your head is moving, Kelly, and the balls are staying put, it's because there isn't any motion, any force being added.
Okay, can somebody help me? I'm just standing. I'm scared of this.
Awesome.
There we go.
Okay.
Then Kelly, look at the. Oh, mine's falling. This is so fun, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, there you go. Uh-huh. You got it.
That is
looking great.
Really.
See, look, Kelly, and then you can turn around like this.
Oh, so I can move. Okay.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
And then if the balls just kind of generally stay in the same direction, it's because there's no force that was applied to it.
Got you. Okay.
You just kind of have a little fun.
Yes, do it.
Playing with your motion and force.
And the kids get to do this at Steam Break?
They sure do, yeah. And it's
Now when I stop, it keeps going.
Feel like I am the sun and these are the planets.
Yes, absolutely.
You are the sun, I am the moon. You are the words, I am the tune.
Awesome.
Okay, what's next?
So we have a fun little game. We're going to grab our pint glass here. Our glass, and we are going to make our egg drop into our glass. Okay. Now, we're not gonna use gravity to do it, because that'd be way too easy, right?
Yeah.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a little force to show inertia. So let's put our pie pan on. Now, one thought though, once you stick that egg on there and then you smack your pie tin, where do you think the egg's gonna go?
Hit our producer gauge.
Absolutely, yes, because it has way too much force on it, it's not gonna really go where we want it to, which is the pint glass. So what we're gonna do is add a little bit of a buffer that's gonna absorb the extra force. So let's pop that on.
So does it need to be sideways like this?
Yes,
yeah. Okay.
Put your egg sideways.
Make sure.
And then we might wanna do it one at a time, just make sure we go the right way. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a nice big smack to the side.
Oh gosh, I'm nervous!
The pint glass is hopefully the egg will drop into the pint glass.
Oh my goodness, this is like pulling the tablecloth out. Under and all the dishes.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. And it all stays in place. The inertia of the egg will stay put. Everything will move, and then it'll drop.
I want to see you do
it first. Yeah, you do it first.
All right, let's go
first.
For it. Here, let me make sure this is out of the way.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay. All right, are you ready?
Scared.
Yeah.
3, 2, 1.
That was close. So do it lighter?
Yeah, do it a little bit lighter than
okay,
I did.
Ready? Okay, ready? I'll do it light. Ready? This is fun.
This is so scary.
1, 2, 3.
Oh. Wait a minute.
I did it too light now, Kelly.
All up to you, Kelly.
Oh, God. Oh. Okay, wait.
Too light. I don't do it too light.
Yeah.
This is very scary.
Okay. Wait, let's do it again. One more time.
Here we go.
One more time.
You've got it.
Wait, I gotta do it. Okay.
Yay! There we go.
Great job.
We made it.
All right.
There we go.
So our last one is going to be a fun little memorable experience for y'all to remember to come visit us at Steam Break. This is going to be a chemical reaction. So we're gonna take our glove, pop it on real quick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Does everybody need a glove?
Everyone needs a glove, and everyone needs glasses to be safe.
All right.
I have built-in glasses.
On our dominant hand.
Sure.
Okay.
Okay. Oh.
Okay.
Here we go. Doctor.
So we're going to make a chemical reaction. What we have is hydrogen peroxide at 35%, so it's a higher concentration.
Okay.
And then we have manganese dioxide in powder form. And what we're going to do is we're going to drop it in, and steam's going to pop up.
Okay. So each one of these little things.
So you grab one, Cal. Okay.
Yep, absolutely.
Oh, I see. So you're going to drop that.
This seems awfully big.
I was about to say, here, why don't you take a smaller one?
Okay, so drop it in.
Do we do it at the same time or separate?
Let's go ahead and do it at the same time.
Ready, set,
three, two, one.
Run and... go!
Oh, wow!
Are you kidding me? That is amazing!
Wow, so this is steam?
This is steam, absolutely.
Could you give yourself a facial with that, or no?
I mean, honestly, you can gently see right around the sides. It stays a little warm. I don't know if you'd want that smell.
You would call a chemical facial.
That's wonderful. So we have a fun time with Steam Break, but also if you have your avid learners, we also have Steam Camps all week. And then, of course, remember, if you can't make it over to Discovery Center next week, we can have camps all summer long.
So the Steam Break is next week. We have, there's the little poster right there. It's next week. Mm-hmm. And if people want to sign up, where can they find more information?
If you can go to our website at discoverycenter.org, you can have all the information there right for you.
Okay, can you do yours for us?
Yes, let's
so much
do
fun.
It.
Oh, that
it reminds me of the I Dream of Jeannie and the smoke coming out of the bottle.
I love it so much.
Are you ready?
Ready?
Science is fun, kids.
It really is.
It is.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, thanks so much, Alex.
Thank you.
This is so fun.
Appreciate you. All right.
Up next is Kaylee's Craft Corner right after this. I don't know how she can compete with this, though.
I don't know either.
I don't know, Kaylee.
Crazy good.
This is so, that, I want to do that one over and over again.
Right?